On the western edge of the Greenland ice sheet, there's a stretch of dirty grey ice known as the Dark Zone. 400 kilometers long and 100 kilometers wide, this dark zone is melting somewhere between double and 10 times the rate of the white ice around it. For a while, scientists thought it was a frozen relic from a time in Earth's history when the planet was covered in dust. But we now know that the dark zone isn't just a fossil, it's actually growing. To understand what's happening on the ice, we have to start this story a long way from Greenland. In many places around the world, forest fires are getting worse. More frequent, more widespread, and more ferocious. In the last few years in particular, North America has suffered record-breaking wildland fires.
We have very good empirical evidence that shows that the hotter the climate is, the more likely fires occur. And that's because it's drying out fuels, it's creating the fire weather conditions for more wildland fires, but more importantly, it's also expanding our fire-prone ecosystems north. So areas that didn't used to burn now burn.
That's Professor McCarty.
My name is Jessica McCarty, and I am an assistant professor of geography at Miami University in Oxford, Ohio.
She explained that not only is climate change making fires worse, fires are in turn driving climate change.
They can release a lot of CO2 in a very short amount of time. So for instance, the fires in British Columbia, which seem to burn every summer now, will release what is equivalent to a small nation's amount of CO2 reported to the UNFCCC in a week.
But CO2 is only part of the picture. Fires also release something called black carbon.
So black carbon is actually the black part of smoke. So you can think of it as soot, right? So colloquially in English, we would call it soot.
Black carbon is a product of burning plant matter or fossil fuels, and it's really good at absorbing heat. Compared to its more famous cousin, carbon dioxide, the amount of black carbon emitted globally is tiny, but its global warming effect is seriously potent. These heat-trapping specks of soot are the third or even second largest man-made contributor to climate change, depending on who you ask. So what's this got to do with that expanse of grubby ice in Greenland? Although much of the dark zone is dust deposited tens of thousands of years ago, it's now growing and getting darker, in part because new debris is settling on the ice. And crucially, that includes black carbon from forest fires. Because whereas CO2 can hang around in the atmosphere for a century, black carbon, being much heavier, blows about for just days or weeks before falling back to Earth. With forest fires, the intense heat from the blaze lifts the black carbon high into the atmosphere, where it can be blown thousands of miles before depositing. From satellite data, we know that black carbon from forest fires in North America can travel all the way to Greenland, where it can land on the ice. So why does this layer of black carbon cause the ice to melt so much faster?
I'm Alun Hubbard. I'm a professor of glaciology at Tromso and Aberystwyth universities.
When we spoke to Professor Hubbard, he had just come off the Greenland ice sheet, where researchers have been using drones to study the makeup of the sooty mixture on the ice.
When you darken the ice sheet, you effectively turn up the melt knob by a couple of orders of magnitude. So it's a really, really important modulator of melt on the Greenland ice sheet.
That's because of something called the albedo effect. Light colors reflect solar energy, dark colors absorb it. Bright, snow-covered ice reflects up to 90% of the sun's energy back into space, a crucial process for cooling the planet. The remaining 10% of the solar energy is absorbed, which causes it to melt. But in the dark zone, more than 70% gets absorbed, rapidly speeding up the melting process. But that's not all that's going on. Not only does the dust and black carbon mixture cause the ice to absorb more of the sun's rays, it provides nutrients for algae, which blooms on the ice and darkens it further.
So effectively, when you put carbon nutrients basically minerals, fertilizer, and water together on the ice sheet, it creates the perfect conditions for breeding algae. And it's actually pigmented algae that are actually causing the intensification of the dark zone.
Scientists call this a bioalbedo effect.
It's effectively pouring baby bio over the ice sheet and then giving it 24-hour sunlight and a bit of moisture.
The Greenland ice sheet is already responsible for about 25% of global sea level rise, up from 5% in 1993. Hubbard described what's going on in the dark zone as a wild card, a potentially unpredictable factor we urgently need to understand. Because the melting caused by the darkened ice isn't just contributing to rising sea levels, it's increasing the overall warming of the planet. By reflecting heat, ice sheets help keep the planet cool. So when they melt and shrink, the planet gets warmer. And that means fires get more frequent and move north, spitting more black carbon onto the ice and making it melt. It's a feedback loop. Wildfires are by far the biggest source of black carbon in the Arctic. But black carbon is settling on icy regions all over the planet, and it comes from agricultural burning, coal plants, and ship engines, as well as forest fires.
Yes, it's everywhere. So we track it in the Andes, the Andean glaciers. It happens in the Himalayas, in Kenya. There are some glaciers in Kenya. It's happening on Kilimanjaro. We know it happens in Antarctica. It definitely happens in the Arctic, so not just Greenland, but the Arctic Circle.
And here's the problem. We aren't very good at accurately tracking black carbon. A 2013 study concluded that because of gaps in emissions data, existing climate models could be underestimating black carbon's climate-changing contribution by up to a factor of 3. In fact, the UN guidelines for monitoring carbon emissions from fires don't currently require countries to track black carbon at all. The science on black carbon and the climate is still young, and it's hugely complicated. But the more we learn, the clearer it becomes that the rise in global fires is not just a result of climate change. Left unchecked, they could accelerate the process.